Presented by Premier Glass, suppliers of UPVC windows, doors, and conservatories.
It's simply amazing, Premier Glass.
Cloud and rain spreading into our area from the southwest by dawn. The low 10 Celsius, that's 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Later today, rain at first turning to drizzle by midday. It'll become rather warm and close by the afternoon. Maximum temperature 20 Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit. The outlook Friday and the weekend, rather cool and showery. The temperature now is 10 Celsius, that's 50 degrees Fahrenheit.
The best mix of golden oldies.
Okie dokie, me old culture lovers. It's the Midnight Line on Beacon and WABC. There we go, just WABC online. Good morning. How are we this morning? Well, we do hope. Well, we do hope. Right over there, right over there. Okie dokie, what have we got for you this morning? Well, it's provided by my National Research Department, and jolly good value they are as well. They have large offices in London. They spend all day, every day, 24 hours a day, just listening to the news, reporting the news, and bringing you the news. They call themselves the Daily Telegraph, and they don't realise that for just 40p, or whatever it costs, not that I ever pay my paper bills, of course. On that basis, is it corner shops? They're fabulous. I like the local shops because I went in to buy. Here we go. The life and times of a radio presenter. I went in to buy a packet, not a packet, a jar of pickled onions, which, incidentally, my friend Caroline works at the factory. There you go. Small world, isn't it? So I went to buy some pickled onions, and they were £1.27, and I only had £1.26 with me. And the guy said, it's okay. He said, don't worry about that. I said, just have the pickled onions. He said, I'd trust you for a penny. And I jokingly said, well, yes, because I wouldn't leave the country. Well, ha, 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 because the joke's on you. Because this show is being broadcast from Borneo, which doesn't have an extradition treaty with the UK as such, so I'm away with me 1p. Anyway, they send us copies of the Daily Telegraph out to Borneo. Oh, all right, I'm not really in Borneo at all. It's just a clever ruse I thought up to try and get out of paying the 1p back. Shucks. Anyway, the Daily Telegraph, God bless them, because for 40p you get all these stories and stuff like that. I reckon they get so many mentions they ought to start sending me some money. That's the way to do it. So what are we talking about this morning? We're talking about this. We're talking about the free vote that is going to take place on the age of gay consent. Now, currently, if you're a heterosexual, you can do sex when you... It's all right, it's after midnight. Well, the kids are in bed, you can say sex. Doesn't matter. You can say it. Currently, 16 years old for you've got to be to do sex if you're a heterosexual. But if you're a homosexual, you've got to be 21. Now, there's obvious differences. Are the differences there for a good reason? I mean, do you need to be more mature to handle homosexuality than you do to handle heterosexuality? Because you could argue that you've got to be sort of a bit older because society's got a real, whichever way you want to look at it, society has a real downer on gays or homosexuals or whatever you call them. Which I'll probably get in trouble for saying that now, but I don't know the politically correct way to refer to a gay person. I mean, I know how not to, but I don't quite know how. Anyway, you just bear with me. So, it's a free vote on reducing the age of consent from 21. Now, first of all, I want you to imagine that you are a member of the Houses of Commons, right? You're a member of the House of Commons, so off you go to the brothel. Or get drunk and have a fight outside Buckingham Palace and get arrested or something like that. If you were voting in the House of Commons about whether or not the age of homosexual consent should be reduced, what would you vote? Because pressure groups want it reduced to the age of 16, the same as heterosexuality. So point one, is that fair? Is it unfair in this day and age, in this enlightened age, to make people feel different just because of their sexuality? The other side of that coin is, as I said before, to say, well, 16 is a bit young, isn't it? Because, I mean, how could you possibly come to terms with your sexuality by the time you're 16? How can you do that? And you could say, is there a difference between coming to terms with being a homosexual and coming to terms with being a heterosexual? Or do both groups sort of come to terms with it at round about the same age and in round about the same way? 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. Would you compromise? Would you make the age of consent for gay people, would you make it 18? Or would you consider actually upping the age of consent? That's probably a really saucy joke in there somewhere, but I just can't think of it at the moment. Would you consider upping the age from 21 to maybe 25 or 26? Or do you think, nah, totally and utterly unworkable? Do the laws as they stand at the moment discriminate unfairly against homosexuals, do you believe? Or do you think, no, it's a good law, it's there for a purpose, it's there to protect people? Is this true? What do you reckon? 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. We'll go to the lines in a moment. First of all, who has been writing? Another snotty letter, I feel, from George Wakefield, who's out of our area anyway. And I seem to remember, George, if this is the same one, you sent me a rather obnoxious letter not so long ago. Anyway, it goes, "Dear Ian, I listen to the programme most nights and usually agree with most of what you have to say." I never really say anything. Middle line, that's me. "However, I was a little taken aback to hear you say that the best rock pop music at the moment is being made by the old guard as typified by Donald Fagan. I honestly don't remember saying that. I think I might have said that I quite like Snowbound. That was about it. Now, I'm a Donald Fagan fan from way back. I love the Steely Dan album." See, I didn't even know he was in Steely Dan. Hey, 19. "And the Night Flight, but Camo Unpronounceable, his new CD album, is a massive disappointment. Is this really the same bloke who wrote Haitian Divorce and Maxine?" Probably is, yes. "Whatever happened to the melodies? For the most part, Camo Unpronounceable, Camo Kyriad or something, seems to consist of tuneless, easy listening music, mechanical funk that's hardly worth waiting 5 minutes, let alone 12 years for. Grump, grump, grump. Fagan, you got to pick a pocket or two, has been one of my heroes for nigh on two decades, but I can't help but think that he's finally lost it. Creative genius is a fragile and mercurial thing." You're so right, George. "And I think that Big Don's best work is behind him. Of course, I'll be delighted if he proves me wrong. Anyway, why not haul out some of your Fagan LPs, well, largely because I haven't actually got any, and play them on the show instead of all this sweet bowling glitter crap you're so fond of." Ha! To you. "A Steely Dan equals boring, my friend. Bowie and Roxy music were the only glam rockers worth listening to." "Can I play Maxine?" I can write a lot more cruelly type of letter than that, I'm afraid, George, when I get round to doing that. I can't help thinking that I recognise that address from somewhere. Anyway, who else has been writing? Well, we've got the crappy postcard competitions in full swing. If you've got a totally tacky postcard that you want to send us, you could win a prize, you could. And it's a fabulous prize. It's a prize that's beyond your wildest dreams, because it's a Culture Lovers Do It at Midnight t-shirt. Altogether now, there's only six of them going to be made. I'm having one of them, so that leaves five of them for the rest of you to fight over, doesn't it? And one way you can win one is to send me a tacky postcard. Now, I'm not entirely sure that this is actually an entry for the tacky postcard competition, but it is certainly a postcard. And it's from Tony, who phones the show. And, it's a picture of the Matryoshka. There we go, that's what he looks like. Looks a bit like Lenny Henry with a false beard. But thanks for that. There we go. I won't enter it to the tacky postcard competition, because I don't think you meant it for that, somehow. There's also a ticket. No, it's not a ticket, because admission's free, donations welcome. To Benjamin Krem on the emergence of Matryoshka, the world leader. This is being held opposite Euston Station at the Friends House on Tuesday, June the 1st, July 27th, August the 24th of this year. So if you're at a loose end, don't bother going to the June the 1st one, unless you've got a time machine. 6:30 for 7. I don't know if there's a bar, it doesn't say. But I have noticed on my odd incursion into a religious meeting that regrettably they don't seem to have that many bars, which is a bit of a bottomer, really, isn't it? Somebody sent me a really bad postcard and I've kind of mislaid it. Where is it? No, it's not that one. It's not that one. Really bad one. It was a gate. It's probably on this little thingy over there. Yeah. Well, just bear with me. I better get them. And if people are going to send them in, I suppose the least I can do is get them, really, isn't it? There we go. There we go, two entries. One, Public Enemy number one. It's a picture of a seagull. Yeah, what a crap postcard that is. "Ian, I thought you were Public Enemy number one, or is that just your bike? Well, anyway, greetings from Blackpool, especially to all the 2nd Battalion under the duvet Culture Lovers in Helzowin. Yes, Blackpool, surf, sea, sand, seagulls, soggy sandwiches, and of course the famous Blackpool sewage. I think most of the rubbish floats across from Anfield." Ha ha ha, up the villa. Abianto. From Packstar and Company. So you didn't think I knew what Abianto was. Well, I do, because I'm an educated sort of chap. Another really tacky postcard. This is the entrance gate to a delightful garden which surrounds the Church of St. Lawrence, Darlaston. There we go. And it's basically a picture of a tree with a gate by it. Very nice. We'll hold it up. There you go. That really is bad. It says, here's the most awful postcard I've ever seen, so I bought it for you. You're very kind. Up Eric, up the captain, and up the chimney. I'd better win. All the best, Stunning Steve Hodson. Thank you, Stunning Steve Hodson. You want to drop me a tacky postcard, 267 Technol Road in Wolverhampton, 28 Castle Street in Shrewsbury. And finally, Esther. Dear Ian Perry, a few lines. I've written a few times, no luck. I hope this address will find you. Yes, it did, actually, though. You sent it to 28 Castle Street in Wolverhampton, which I suppose is sort of hedging your bets a bit, really, isn't it? But it finally found me. It's from Maggie. Maggie Shaw, I think it is, in Bramble Green. She says, I've been listening to you for ages. I'm still waiting for a phone. Once I get cable, a phone cable. I'll give you a ring then. Please could you send me a photo? I'm on my own a lot. I can't sleep at night. One of those. Your show is a comfort. Love, Big E. And a few others. I can't think of the names right now. Fair enough. Thanks for that. Finally got me. There you go. This proves it can happen. Okay, what are we doing this morning? We're talking about the age of consent for homosexuals and whether or not it should be kept as it is at the moment at 21. There's going to be a free vote on it in the House of Commons. This means that it's a vote of conscience, so they won't be whipped into shape like they're being for the Maastricht Treaty thingy later in the week. Pressure groups, homosexual pressure groups, they want the age of consent to be lowered to 16 years old, the same as it is for heterosexuals. Some people think that a compromise age of 18 might have more chance of being passed by the Commons, or it could stay at 21. Now, if you were voting, it's a free vote, how would you vote? On this line here, get your calls in early. That's the trick. That is the trick to getting on the show. Get your calls in nice and early. We got Jane on this line. Good morning, Jane.
Hello.
Hello. Age of homosexual consent, should it be lowered to 16?
No, I don't think so.
Why not?
Because I don't think they matured properly at that age. I just don't think...
You don't think, do you?
Yeah, I do.
No, so you just left it. You just said, I don't think.
I was talking to someone.
Well, talk to me.
Alright.
Otherwise, I'll cut you off. Okay, there we go, like that. Simple enough. No, just joshing. Go on, I'll give you a second chance. Right, why should heterosexuals be able to lawfully enjoy sex at 16 and not homosexuals? What's the difference?
Well, I think at 16, the girl matures more than the lad. And, They mature like 3 years above, don't they?
Yeah, but I don't know if you noticed, but it actually takes two people to have heterosexual sex.
Well, I did notice.
And one has to be a girl and one has to be a boy.
Yeah.
But boys can still do heterosexual sex at 16. But
I just don't agree with gays anyway.
Why not?
Because, I mean, like, if they want to be gay, then that's fair enough, going their own ass, but the way they plastic over, it just makes me sick anyway. Because it's abnormal and they should be put out.
So being gay is abnormal, and they should be put down. Why?
Because they make me sick.
Why? What makes you sick about them? Everything. What makes you sick about them?
Because they are. They're just dirty, and there's just no need for it.
So homosexual sex is dirty, there's no need for it. What about heterosexual sex? Have you got problems with that?
No.
No, that's okay, is it?
Yeah, because that's natural.
Well, you're not saying this because you happen to be a heterosexual, are you?
No, I'm not talking about me, am I?
I don't understand.
I'm just talking about you. Just asked.
If somebody,
about gay, and I'm just telling you anyway.
Well, I'm not sure that's more of a. I'm not sure that's actually an opinion. It's more of a sort of bigotry.
Well, I'm just telling you. I don't agree with it. I think they're dirty. And if I find that bloke that's killing them, I'll give him my wages.
Would you now? Well, there you go. Obviously, not a member of the Liberal Party. That's Jane, 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. She says she couldn't care what the age of homosexual consent is, because as far as she's concerned, gays are abnormal and they should be put down. Do you agree with Jane or do you disagree? 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. Next on the lines, we've got Vicky. Good morning, Vicky.
Hello, Ian.
Hello, Vicky.
How are you? All right then, dear?
Very well, thank you. Very well.
Good. Isn't it amazing how some people get steamed up about what other people do in the privacy of their own homes or whatever?
Well, I came to the conclusion the National Front had thrown out early.
Yeah, I can agree with that, yeah. It's funny, isn't it? The age of consent for gay men is 21, and the age of consent for gay women is 16. Bit unfair, really, isn't it?
I didn't realise that. For gay women is 16.
That's right, yeah, because when the laws against homosexuality were brought in, because in Queen Victoria's reign, they were going to make it 21 for both men and women until some bright spark pointed out that it was impossible for two women to have sex. I don't know where they grew up, obviously not in them.
Yeah, I had actually heard that Queen Victoria, the reason for that was that Queen Victoria didn't actually acknowledge that homosexuality existed within women.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, so it's a little bit of, somebody didn't inform her properly then, or
so
whatever.
If you cut through the bigotry, though,
mm-hmm.
that Jane Hitler, who was just on the lines, was expressing.
Her Gruber Jane, yeah?
Yeah, that's the one, Oben Gruppenführer.
Mm-hmm.
If you cut through the bigotry, does she have a point when she says that at 16 years old, you can't handle homosexuality?
Well, at 16 years old, can you handle heterosexuality? Think about it.
I did.
Well, we know the vast majority of adolescents go around once a year to try to get it, but are they really mature enough to deal with it?
You have an easier ride as a heterosexual, but then I realised that that's the sort of thing that ends up in Coleman balls in private eye, so I decided to think of something else to say. You have an easier time, don't you, as a heterosexual?
Oh yeah, yeah, things aren't as tough
because all you've
culturally,
got,
yeah.
All you've got to deal with is bonking, really, that's it.
Mm-hmm. But I mean,
And it's something that's actively encouraged by society.
Oh yes, there's nothing worse when you're a teenage lad than not having broken your duck now, is there?
I actually got rid of my duck when I was about 12.
Now, who was breaking the law himself, then?
No, I meant the plastic one that I had in my bath. I see what you meant!
Yes, it's a penny drop, does it?
Losing your virginity. I suppose we can say virginity, it's an adult show, isn't it? Yeah, okay, there we go, virginity.
Dark, yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, I mean, whether you want to... I mean, I'm not saying it does it overtly, but I think society covertly says, yeah, go on, especially if you're a bloke, you know, go on, lose your virginity, that's what we want, yeah, you're not a man till you've done that.
If you're a girl, they turn around and say, no, if you do, then you're a, horrible, nasty person.
But there's a tacit, how could you put it, a tacit acceptance.
Yes,
of heterosexuality. Now, there is not a tacit acceptance of homosexuality.
Well, I've known in the past quite a few gay men who have been very sure from a lot younger than 16 about what their sexuality was. And they went ahead and did it under the age of 21 and just had to make sure that they weren't caught, which I don't think really solves the problem. I mean, if you have two people of the same sex, let's put it that way, in a stable relationship, how does it... good does it do to run around saying, no, you can't do that, you're breaking the law? I think society could concentrate on things that are a lot more, constructive, say, than running around gay bashing.
Is this just another attempt at gay bashing?
Well, I think it always has been. It's always struck me as being unfair that the legal age limit for men was 21 and girls 16. And if you want to do it with a member of the opposite sex, it was still 16.
Why do you think that society in general has such a downer on homosexuality?
Because they're a minority, minority group, let me get my teeth in. I don't know, it just seems to me that we've always, well, for the last 400 or 500 years, we've had really funny ideas about sex ever since we got struck down by all these venereal diseases.
Well, I mean, as a nation, we're not very good about sex, are we?
No, we never have been. You ought to try reading some of Shakespeare's poetry about sex, and it's not very clever.
No, but I mean, we're always embarrassed to talk about it, for a start.
Oh, I'm not.
No, I'm talking as a national characteristic.
Yeah, yeah.
Sex is
right.
Something you do under the duvet with the lights off on a Friday night. If you have to.
Precisely, yes. Yeah, I mean, it just seems to me that, okay, if you're going to have law against something, make sure that the end product serves the, so I would say, national need.
But then is the end product serving the purpose of protecting immature people?
Well, you could say that about the age of consent for heterosexuals, couldn't you? I always think, I mean, there's loads and loads of children, they are children at 16, I think, some of them, who go around quite legally indulging in sex when they've got no business to, really.
But then you've got to be pragmatic about it and say that heterosexual sex is acceptable.
Well, yeah.
To society in general.
Well, yes, but how many teenage girls have you, that get pregnant?
I was going to say.
Children.
Thank you. How many do I know in the biblical sense of the word?
Well,
absolutely
no,
none.
No, I wasn't speaking about your personal after-hours life, Ian. I don't get touchy now. I'm just saying...
And anybody who says I do will be hearing from my solicitor, Sue Grabbit, and run in the morning.
Sweet, pal.
They're the same ones who are representing Carhill and...
There are loads and loads of young teenage girls running around indulging legally in sex, and the byproduct is a baby which they are not emotionally mature enough to cope with, so you can throw that argument back as well.
So then should the heterosexual age be hiked up a bit?
Well, in some parts of America, the age of consent is 18, isn't it?
You see, I'm not saying that any law that you pass is going to be workable anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But what you're doing as society, if you pass a law like that, is giving a workable moral judgment. Yeah? You're passing moral judgment on when it's acceptable and when it isn't.
Well, adolescence is a time of experimentation anyway, isn't it? I mean, sexually as well as with everything else. And I do think that a lot of teenagers go through phases where they think they may be homosexual or bisexual or whatever. They end up growing out of it in the end, so you could turn around and say that to protect them from, you know, jumping in with both feet too soon, the age limit needs to be pretty high.
Did you ever consider at any point during your adolescence that you may be gay?
No, I didn't, but you heard the old saying, haven't you, dear? Nobody is 100% homosexual or heterosexual. They all have elements off the other, if you like. Did you see the rainbow when it was on a couple of weekends ago?
No, you come to mention it. I was probably in the pub that night.
Well, it was it was a lot of crap from some point of view, but...
What was it about?
Well, it was about this girl's adolescence and how she couldn't make up her mind whether she wanted men or women. I mean, she went out and had an affair with a woman teacher for a while. Then she decided she'd go back onto men again.
And this was all shown on telly, was it?
Oh, yeah, full frontal and everything, pal.
I wish I'd have taped it, at least.
It was just as good as Lady Chatterley.
I never saw that either.
Missed a good romp there.
Did I?
Yes, you did. It was all good, clean, dirty fun.
And this is what we want on British television. If you were going to vote, then,
mm-hmm.
What would you vote?
Well, I'd vote to lower the age limit to 16.
And you think that at 16, people are capable of dealing with homosexuality in the same way that they are with heterosexuality?
Well, I don't care what the age... I think that most gay people, or gay adolescents, or adolescents who think they're gay, don't care what the legal age limit is anyway. They just go ahead and do it. So you might as well make life easier for them and drop the age limit so nobody's running around wasting time and energy trying to prosecute people for doing things that they want to do.
I must admit, from the gay people that I know, most of them have said that, although not all of them, but most of them have said, well, I knew that I was gay when I was a kid.
Yeah, that's what I've heard as well from quite a few people, quite a few of my past acquaintances.
Okie dokie, but you would vote to lower the age of consent to 16?
Yeah, I would.
Thanks for your call, Vicky.
Ta-ra.
754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. It's the Midnight Line on Beacon and WABC. What are we talking about? We're talking about a vote that's going to take place in the House of Commons. I was close. The House of Commons about lowering the age of consent for gay people. We've had differing opinions. Vicky says that she would vote for the age of consent to be lowered to 16. And before that, we spoke to Oban Grupp and Fiora Jane, who said, as far as she's concerned, gays are totally abnormal, and as far as she's concerned, she'd have them all put down. 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. Nothing like a bit of variety, eh?
Did you know that Barclays was the first bank to reopen on Saturdays? And did you know that we were the first to introduce credit cards?
I appear to have forgotten my money.
Then, madam, may I recommend the rubber gloves with a side serving of lemon detergent?
We were also the first to offer bankers dedicated to students.
Well, how's it going, you most excellent bespectacled dude?
Well, I'd like to deposit my grant check, please.
I'm audacious.
And we were also the first bank to offer personal bankers.
So, Mr. Worthington,
call me Reginald.
Oh, right, Reginald.
Well, please. Reggie. Oh, Reg.
Reg.
I like my wife to call me Squidgy Chops.
Oh.
Greet first from Barclays.
Hollybush. On Sunday, August the 1st, Hollybush Aquatics plays host to the annual BKKS Mid-Staffs Koi Show. From 11 a.m. you can consult the experts, talk to the dealers and see some of the finest koi in the Midlands, all undercover. Admission is just £1 and children under 14 go free. For details, call Hollybush Aquatics on 09-22-418-050.
Hollybush.
Hollybush Aquatics, M6 Junction 11, Warstone Road, Shares Hill.
Lady Jane stared from the house to where the forest thrust its massive trunks up into the rain. Oh, she hated the house, yearned to cast off its comforts for the rough warmth of Fella's hut. Unable to bear it any longer, she fled to the wood. Its branches raked at her hair and body as she ran, uncaring and abandoned. Suddenly, she stopped. Oh, she hated the scratching. Now she longed to be pampered again with the bath, shower and skincare products she knew were reduced by up to 20% at Superdrug. The depilatories reduced by up to 25%. To lie in warm sun protected by sun creams reduced by up to a third. Most of all, she wanted no one who'd save 15% on Kodak films at Superdrug to find her, because she suddenly remembered she had no clothes on. And where was Fellas? Had he gone to Superdrug, where condoms are reduced by up to a third and, like all their reductions, will stay down all summer? In her anguish, her voice rang through the brutal wood. There's only one price, Fellas. The Superdrug price.
Beacon Radio. Midnight Line on Beacon and WABC. 754123 in Wolverhampton. 236235 in Shrewsbury. Talking about the age of homosexual consent. And whether it should be lowered from 21 to, as pressure groups are claiming, 16. They want it lowering to 16. There's going to be a free vote in the House of Commons, which means that MPs will vote with their conscience. And interestingly enough, my research department tell me that it would only take a few dozen Tories to ensure that the law was, that it was passed as law, because Labour and Liberal Democrat MPs all support reducing the age to 60. Who have we got next? We've got Barking Mad Dave. Hello.
It's Super Dave now.
Super, Barking Super Mad Dave.
Right, Ian. But these gay bolt things, 21 to 16, well, you know I disagree with that, but...
Why do you? I don't know you disagree with it. Why do you disagree with it?
They shouldn't conclude your vote. I mean, be honest. I mean, you want to vote for them people, what they do. I mean, what they go up to is, that's their principle of mind. But, what sex can you call it, Ian?
Sorry?
What sex can you call that? What they do? Come on.
Well, they call it homosexual sex.
Yeah,
what do you call it?
Well, no, I call it immoral sex, I do.
Immoral?
Yeah, I think it's immoral. I think it's wrong. Well, I mean, a man good with a man, then good to a woman. Don't think that's over, what do you call it? What's the word?
Ah, give up. I haven't brought me
Proportional, I think. Yes, right, yeah.
Over proportional is the word you were searching for, I don't
think. Yeah, that's right, yeah. Because, be honest.
Why is it immoral? Why, if somebody feels like that, is it immoral? Why should you interfere with what somebody else wants to do?
Well, if they're...
Are they hurting anybody?
If they're only glad themselves, it's up to them, it's their bodies, isn't it? But, come on, be honest, guys, right, what they do with their bodies, it's up to them. Well, they can do 16, 18, 21, it's up to them. But surely don't put it to a vote and vote for them, because they ain't worth a vote.
Well, it's good. You have to have laws governing these sort of things, don't you?
You can't have a law
to have laws about sex. Otherwise, 8-year-old kids could have sex by law, and that is clearly
guys,
not...
Guys are right on their own side. What they do, it's up to them. It's their mind, they tell you what to do with it. But you can't call that sex soon. It's not sex. It's not sex at all. It's sex is with a man and a woman. With a man and a man, well, what can you call it?
What about a woman and a woman?
Pardon?
What about a woman and a woman?
You mean two lesbians, we'll call them, yeah. Well,
let's call them lesbians, because that's what they're called.
Okay,
right.
Yeah, lesbians, fair enough, right. Well, they're kind of probably sex, can they? Obviously, because they're the females. But
that isn't sex either, then?
Well, it's just play sex, I suppose, and it's just not playing around for sex, in sex.
And then do you find lesbians as obnoxious as you seem to find homosexuals?
Well, it's a question that's got to be debated anyway. I mean, two guys, they go together, it's up to them. Nothing against that. Right, but surely they can't vote on that, because it's not right. I mean,
to vote, otherwise you could have 10-year-old gays, couldn't you? So you have to have a law somewhere.
Yeah, they shouldn't make a law, should they? I mean, guys, it shouldn't be guys. I mean, if a bloke is a bloke, how can they have sex? Come on, you tell me, where can they get sex from? You tell me.
Well, they seem to think they're having sex.
Yeah, I'll pretend they're having sex, not right. They're pretending they're having sex, I suppose.
So they only pretend. Well, as far as they're concerned, they're having sex, and I think you have to accept that.
We can't accept that. It's not right. It's not right in whatever it is on the earth or whatever.
Are you saying that there should be no laws governing homosexuality?
No, that's right. There should be no laws at all. But
you could have, quite legitimately, you could have a 12-year-old kid practicing homosexuality.
I mean, I'm 36, right? I'm a virgin. I've never sex with a woman, never have done. I admit that on the air. I'm thirsty. I've never sexed with them. I've been with them, but I've never sexed with them.
You've never had sex with a woman at 36?
No, never.
Why not?
Well, I can't do it at all. I've been to the therapy, I've been to this, but that. There's something, you can't do it. Just try it hard to explain. It's just, you can't do it. Something in body, what's stopping me? I don't know what it is. I've had it for years.
What, don't women turn you on?
Well, yeah, they do, yeah, but in my other ways. I mean, I don't have sex and I pleasure me other ways. But, see, I know a guy named John, he's homosexual, right? He's honest and straight. I know him through a friend. Now he's straight. He told me reason why he was gay, explained it why. That's a different thing. They get abused when they're young, or something happens, or mum changes, or vice versa. I've seen a film called Sex Freaks one day. You should have seen that.
I don't think I'd really want to see that, thank you very much.
No, well, okay, but fair enough. If they keep to their own soul, do what they want, it's up to them. Govern their own body, it's up to them. But surely, you know, I mean...
But you have to have laws, Dave.
Laws? But for what reason?
Otherwise you could be 10 years old, couldn't you?
Yeah.
And you don't want that, do you?
Not really, no.
So you have to have a law then, don't you?
I suppose, yeah, look, what, yeah, yeah, law, yeah, in the right way, in the proper way, not law like they do. I'm totally against, a lot of people are against that. I read the paper the other day about it, said that shouldn't be law about it. Because what they do, it's up to them, but it's not law, it's not sex, it's just pretending sex, you know, it's just one of their ways.
But you wouldn't, as I say, want a 10-year-old doing it, would you? Therefore, you have to have laws that govern the regulation of that behaviour.
I suppose you're right there, yeah, but if they want to make it law, it's up to them. You know, they'll make it law, the government's involved for them, and it's up to them.
What would you vote, Dave, if you were in the unlikely event of you being an MP?
Well, if I vote, I'd vote for 30.
So you couldn't be a homosexual until you were 30?
Yeah, I'd vote more at 30, that's reasonable, I think.
Okie dokie, we'll see what everybody else thinks. There we go. There's Dave. Make your own minds up. 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. We've got Stephen next. Good morning, Stephen.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning. Now, what would you vote?
Yeah, I think the vote consent should be lower to 16, really.
Why?
Because, like, people make them on minds up, can't they?
But at 16, do you have the necessary psychological resources to make your own mind up?
Yeah, really. It's like, I mean, past your teenage, and all that kind of finger.
Well, when I was 16 years old, right, I was a kid.
Yeah, but like, if people want to be gay and that, they've met their own mind up, can't they?
But then, isn't there all sorts of pressures on you at 16? Isn't there all sorts of uncertainties that you can't really be sure whether you're gay, heterosexual, or asexual, androgynous, or whatever, until you're a bit older?
Yeah, but it's up to them, eh? Like, they can be with one of them older if they want.
But surely you have to protect teenagers who are still children from this abnormal practice.
Yeah, but I think it should be allowed to 16, really. Because, like, they've made their own mind up then. They're old enough to think what they want to be.
That's at 16 years old?
Yeah.
And yet the defence, or one of the defences that's been used for the two girls who've just been released on a free pardon from the sentence they were serving for smuggling heroin, one of the defences was that they were very young, they were very naive.
Well, to them, eh?
Well, I mean, if teenagers are that naive, how can you allow them to explore homosexual sex? I mean, what sort of psychological damage is it going to do?
I don't know.
Heaps, I would reckon. Okay, who have we got next? We have got Sonia. Sonia's on this line. Good morning, Sonia.
Morning.
Good morning. Hi. Very, very businesslike, Sonia. And this is your first time?
Yep.
With me?
Yes, it is.
Well, here you are, and you're cruising the airwaves at the midnight line. Now then, Sonia, what would you vote?
I don't know, actually. I'm in an hour now of listening to everybody. I think 18 myself.
Middle for diddle, as I say.
Yeah, really, I don't think there should be a law against gay people. I mean, there should be, but there shouldn't be. It's like they're outcast, like they're different. They should choose the way they want to be themselves. But there shouldn't be a law.
But with the best will in the world, they are different from mainstream society.
Yeah, but then to them, we're different because they're gay. That's normal to them. And like to them, we're not normal.
Yeah, I remember the last time we did a phone show around the topic. Apparently I'm a breeder, apparently.
Oh, right.
That's a derogatory term for a heterosexual, is it? We're breeders, we are.
Oh, right.
Stephen just said, why not 16? Why wouldn't you vote for 16? Because Stephen said he'd vote for 16 because he believed that at 16 you can make your own mind up about things.
still kids, really, at 16. Like, you got school, they're still at school, they don't know what they're doing, and they don't want to make their minds up, like, about other things besides that.
Aren't you at 18?
Yeah, I suppose, but you've grown up a bit more, haven't you? You're, like, you're a bit out in the world, you're a bit more open. I mean, you're at 16, you're still at school, aren't you? Well, most people are.
Well, there's quite a few people still at school at 18, and there's certainly a huge majority of 18-year-olds have never left home and don't know life outside the home.
True.
I mean, at 18, because and we've heard a few instances of homophobia in the last few phone calls.
Yeah.
Now, they at 18, could you deal with that homophobia?
I don't know. I mean, at 16, you know, if you're like heterosexual, you know if you fancy someone or not. So you, if you're old enough to be six like that, you must be old enough to make your mind up if you're gay or not, I suppose.
Have you got any gay friends?
I know a couple, but not really well. But, I mean, I'm not against them at all. A lot of most people don't like gay people, do they? I don't know why. They just think they're dirty. They're not dirty at all. They just should make their own minds up. But I suppose 18 to 21 it should be, not 16.
And but, you reckon that you... Well, should you have heterosexuals at 16?
I don't know, Rick. I don't know. When you're 16, I don't know, because people just do things anyway. I mean, it's got to be. You're going to make a law, but people aren't going to stick to the law, are they? Because people aren't going to know what other people are doing.
No, I don't, as I said before, I don't believe that it's a workable law as such. I think it's more of a moral stance.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it would be practically impossible to enforce. But, I mean, you take the example. Do you believe that, I don't know how old you are.
22.
Do you believe that kids today grow up quicker?
Yeah, well, it has been the past about 3-4 years. People have grown up quicker, things happen quicker. Like, people start smoking earlier and everything. I don't know, they should...
Because I saw Ian Botham's son on the telly before. And he's 15 years old. He looks about 25.
That's it. You can't tell people's ages these days. You don't know how old anybody is. There should be a law, but there shouldn't be, if you know what I mean. I don't know. I don't think they should... It's like they're being outcast as though they're different. They are different, but they're not different. That's the way they want to be.
But then if a law was passed reducing the age of consent, wouldn't it make it look like it was getting... homosexuality was almost getting a parliamentary endorsement?
I suppose it means there are other things that you could make laws for. I mean, being gay is something, like, not really that important, is it?
Why do you think people are gay? There's a theory around at the moment that it's genetic.
I don't know.
See, if it's genetic, then you have absolutely no control over it whatsoever, so laws are reasonably useless.
Unless you, I don't know, if you're just a normal person, not normal, but if you just, you know, fancy the opposite sex, I mean, you can't really say if you, what, you know, gay people would think, how they react, what they feel like, I don't know.
Okie dokie. Listen, I've got to move on, but it didn't hurt a bit, did it, Sonia?
No, I was all nervous, but I'll probably ring you again.
You're a very kind person.
Cheers.
Ta-ra.
Bye.
There we go. Sonia, she said that she would take the middle line and that she would reduce if she was voting on the free vote in the House of Commons. If she was voting on lowering the age of consent for homosexuals, she would lower it to 18. She reckons that 18, yeah, you're pretty well psychologically mature. And you'd be able to deal with homosexuality. So 18, according to Sonia, would be a good age. 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. Next on the lines, we've got more semantic backflips with Johnny Morris and his parrot Jammo. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I got him on me back at the moment.
Well, who?
Oh, Jammo.
He's your parrot.
Yeah.
I think we ought to make
hear
that explicitly
then.
Clear.
Hear him then.
Yes.
Oh, he's great. He just moans a bit when I get on the phone because I can't join the attention.
And you have to show parrots lots of attention.
Absolutely.
Do
but I've been listening very intensely to this last 20 minutes, half an hour of your show, and really, it's a bit of a shame, really.
What is?
But why are we concentrating so much in one area? I don't. 92% of the population are okay.
All right, what do you mean by okay?
Well, like me and you.
And that's okay, is it? So being a homosexual is not okay?
Well, you mentioned genetically just recently that the Americans are finding out that maybe, that genetically there may be a problem.
Yes, it's a problem, is it?
Well, don't get me wrong. I mean, if they discover new diseases in the body, they usually say, well, we've got to get it right or not, so I'm only working on that problem.
So is homosexuality, as far as you're concerned, a disease?
No, it's a problem.
I don't suppose it's a problem if you're a homosexual and quite happy about it.
It would be a problem if 92% of the population were homosexual and only 8% were, you know, normal.
Because the race would die out.
There's a good backflip for you, isn't it?
Well, yes, certainly is. One of the finest we've enjoyed in the past couple of weeks. Yeah.
I thought I'd put that to him and find out what he says about that.
There you go.
I talked to Jammo about that.
There you go. You see, there you go. You're sort of exploring a logical avenue of thought, and then suddenly, wham! There he goes.
He was quite right, really. He just dug his claws into my shoulder and said, look here, let's just put the other argument around the other way and see what... Because really, it's right, isn't it?
Well, the one thing that I found very interesting, because, I mean, my background is psychology and physiology and things like that, is that it's a lovely little theory that there could be a rogue gene that's responsible for homosexuality. But one thing it didn't actually... And that gene comes down the female line. One thing it didn't explain was... Or one thing that the nice tight theory didn't explain was female homosexuality.
Well, if you've got it in the male, you must have it in the female.
Well, no, because, but it doesn't...
One gene follows the other, obviously.
But then I would have thought...
2 to 1, they reckon, but...
I would have thought that homosexuals were less likely to go into heterosexual relationships, weren't they?
We certainly got more tolerant with the situation. I mean, at one time we called them queers. 20 years ago, I'm sure we called them queers. And now they're called gays and really tolerated to the fact that you've been talking tonight on the wireless about off the radio, I should say.
I like wireless.
Bringing legality to the situation, and now the Americans have just decided that it may be a disease.
Now, if it's a disease, as the Americans decide, isn't that rather dangerous? Because then, if it's a disease, it needs a cure, doesn't it?
Absolutely, I mean...
But that infers that there are no well-balanced, quite happy with it all, thank you very much, homosexuals
around.
But
isn't it a cure in itself at the moment?
How?
Well, do I have to explain it?
Yes, please.
Well, what do we think about AIDS?
Although the facts of AIDS are that while the incidence of AIDS is slowing up and reducing in the homosexual community, it's increasing in the heterosexual community.
Well, we can say that. But apparently, AIDS weren't about till maybe they haven't come basically into foremost prevalence anyway until the last 20 years. Where obviously, I don't mind calling them gay or queers really, till they've actually got more. Well, what we're doing tonight, we're talking about them, and if you're talking about them, and if the Lords are going to pass a law for them, I mean, there's more of them. I'm not against them, don't get me wrong.
But you did say that the Americans were considering it to be a disease.
Well, no, the papers haven't said that, but if they can actually isolate the gene and say it's anti, I haven't done... well, I might have done a bit of medical work, but if it's anti-gene, obviously it's going to be a problem.
But isn't that a bit Aldous Huxley? Isn't that a bit Brave New World?
Well, I mean,
what sort of... Is it morally right for a doctor to say to the parents, look, OK, you've got a little lad, we know that from the scans, but we also know that he's going
to
be gay. Now, do you want to abort?
No, I don't think that will be necessary, because I think the situation, the way it's working at the moment, will sort itself out, obviously. It's never been... realise that the opposite sex should go together, or, you know, two men shouldn't go together. Sorry to put this so bluntly.
No, it's fair enough.
It's never been... I mean, it doesn't worry me, and sometimes it excites me a bit, actually, but it's never been thought of that two females should go together and two males should go together. I mean, if that's gaining momentum, and it's nice that that should happen, it means that we're not going to reproduce. Fundamentally...
Well, yes, I accept that if 100% of the population were homosexuals, the end of life as we know it, Jim.
Yeah, that's right, and we've got to disappear to another planet and start again somewhere.
But that isn't the case, is it?
It isn't the case at the moment, because 92% of the population are okay, like me and Jammo. He just digs his claw into me and I smack him over the wind.
I can't help, if you look slightly behind what you're saying, you're basically saying that it's not okay to be homosexual.
It isn't. If you were going to push me on that, obviously, I would say, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't want to be homosexual, would you?
Well, no, I have too much fun as a heterosexual.
Yeah, well, that's a damn good reason. I mean, you're going to have to cut down on your partners if you want to go homosexual. Because there's not enough around.
Well, you certainly do. I think in this day and age with heterosexuality.
I mean, you've got to go... men and women have trouble looking for one another. I mean, the agencies apparently have burst open. Did you hear him talk then, my John?
We certainly did, John.
Yeah, he just squeaked at me, he does that now. But, you have a job finding a proper partner, never mind the other sort of partner. And when you find them, you're not quite sure what the relationship is going to be like. I think it's very difficult for the other 8% of the population just to keep going.
If Johnny Morris MP was voting, how would you vote?
I wouldn't vote at all.
You'd abstain, would you?
No. I wouldn't have no age. I wouldn't have no law. I wouldn't do anything. You coerced a couple of your callers tonight into saying what sort of age they would vote for it. You're not going to do that with me.
So then, if there was no law, as I said before, then it would be perfectly acceptable for a 10-year-old to be homosexual.
No, I think we've got a grand argument tonight talking about a very small minority of the public.
Okie dokie. Well, we'll see what that small minority of the public want to come back and say.
Well, I'm sure they'll make a big noise like old Jam. Well, that could be
a man loves his parrot.
But the missus isn't far away.
Ah, fair enough, then. So, you're one of them bisocials, then, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Any feathers will do me, mate.
Okay. All right, John.
Ta-ra.
Ta-ra. There we go. Johnny Morris, controversial as ever. He doesn't believe that homosexuality is in any way... Well, I'm putting words into his mouth, really. But I don't think he approves of it somehow. 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. We've got the Reverend Paul on, and we'll speak to him, along with a few others. If you want to join him, 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. We'll be right back to the lines on the Midnight Line at Beacon and WABC after this stunning, award-winning commercial break.
Lady Jane stared from the house to where the forest thrust its massive trunks up into the rain. How she hated the house, yearned to cast off its comforts for the rough warmth of Fella's hut. Unable to bear it any longer, she fled to the wood. Its branches raked at her hair and body as she ran, uncaring and abandoned. Suddenly, she stopped. How she hated the scratching. Now she longed to be pampered again with the bath, shower and skincare products she knew were reduced by up to 20% at Superdrug. The depilatories reduced by up to 25%. To lie in warm sun protected by sun creams reduced by up to a third. Most of all, she wanted no one who'd save 15% on Kodak films at Superdrug to find her, because she suddenly remembered she had no clothes on. And where was Fellas? Had he gone to Superdrug, where condoms are reduced by up to a third and, like all their reductions, will stay down all summer? In her anguish, her voice rang through the brutal wood. There's only one price, Fellas. The Superdrug price.
4-0-3-4-5-6-8-0-6-8-0. Your bow will go if you don't know where to start. Fiverr in exchange and mart.
This is it. The Daily Star's fantastic new Pot of Gold game starts this Monday. There are two ways to win. Every day in the paper and on Des O'Connor's great new Pot of Gold TV show each Wednesday. Either way, there's thousands of pounds to be won for the next 6 weeks. No purchase necessary. So, pick up your Daily Star, pick up your Pot of Gold game card and say, ooh, ah, Daily Star, say, ooh, ah, Daily Star. Say, ooh, ah, Daily Star, say, ooh, ah.
There's now a great reason to shop on Whitchurch Road in Shrewsbury. Morrison's superb new superstore is now open, bringing you top quality groceries and fresh foods at exceptionally low prices. And this week, there's a free fresh oven-ready chicken when you spend £30 or more.
Morrison's, shop at Morrison's.
Silence was first broadcast on Radio 4 this morning. Okay, who have we got next? It's Beacon and WABC. It's the Midnight Line, 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. We've got Paul next. Good morning, Paul.
Good morning. Got this unearthly hour.
Good morning. Now, you say you're a reverend.
That's it, yes.
Of which persuasion?
Church of England, of course.
Why, of course?
Of course, yeah.
Why, of course?
Of course. Well, the best church, isn't it? Although we are working for the same management.
Okie dokie. Yeah. Okie dokie. What's the third commandment?
The third commandment? Do Do you know all of them?
Yep, I've got them in front of me. What's the third? Get off. Reverend me bottom. Who's next? We'll go to this line here. You see, you ask them a question, as soon as they start stalling for time, you know they're lying to you. Okay, I think we've got Julian on this one. Morning, Julian.
Morning.
Good morning. If he was a reverend, I'm one of the wooden tops.
That's it, that's right, yeah.
Fair enough.
Right, the age of consent.
Yes.
It should be around about the age of 40 to 50.
40 to 50, another liberal.
Until they get a bit of mind on them, really.
A bit of mind?
Aye, a bit of brains.
So you clearly don't believe it's a genetic thing?
Oh, no, not at all, no.
And, well, what do you base this conclusion on?
Well, first of all, I reckon it should be just wiped off the earth to tell you the absolute truth. It is terrible.
Have you ever... Why is it terrible? Why have you got this big downer, Julian?
Well, I'm 23 years of age now.
Yeah?
Yeah, and I'm married, and I've got a kid. And at the age, if I was 16, and I was talking like this now, I'd have said, it's up to them. Yeah?
Right.
But right now, in about 10 years' time, it could increase the population of gays. And someone could approach my kid, say, for instance.
But why should you immediately associate gays with child molesters?
Well, no, I'm not saying child molesters. You know, one gay might come up to my son and say, you know, fancy a good time, you know? Which my son at the age of 12 or 13 may not know, you know, about sex and what have you.
But to be fair, I mean, I've never actually seen recruitment posters.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, you don't. But you'll see them. If you go into your pub or your local pub or other pubs, you'll hear one or two that'll get about, you know, and approach people in different ways. But they're there.
Converting, you reckon?
Well,
has a homosexual ever approached you?
Oh, no. No.
No, and one's never approached me, so on the basis of our collective experience...
But how would they... All right, and how would the population grow of gays? How would you think?
Friends? Does it grow? Does it have to grow?
Oh, it will grow, won't it, don't you think?
Why would it? I don't know. Why would it grow?
Oh, I can imagine just homosexuality is going to keep on growing now. Since it started, it's going to keep on growing.
Why is it... I just don't understand why you think it's going to keep growing.
Well, I reckon it will. In my opinion, I think it will grow.
I mean, you're making it sound like a group of people on a big recruitment drive.
Like us talking about it now. And poor Super Dave out there. Yeah? At the age of 36.
Yeah.
You know, if he's being lonely, not saying he has been, but if he has been lonely, and he gets approached, you know, and of course he might get into it, but it's saying that, you know, he won't like saying that, but he may do. You know, it's our conversation here now taking place, and people listening to us now saying, you know, they're not going to just suddenly say, oh, I'm going to turn gay, you know, but they could do. There may be one out there or two out there.
Well, they're either going to or they're not.
Some people out there may have homosexual tendencies. Yeah.
And so you think it would be better that if they have homosexual tendencies, those tendencies are repressed?
No, not really. Well, I reckon it's... Like, conversation like this, okay, we're getting out our feelings now, but homosexuality shouldn't be heard of. You know what I mean? It would suddenly die away then, eventually. I'd say in about 20 or 30 years, maybe.
It shouldn't... Sorry, I don't understand that. It shouldn't be heard of, so it should only take place behind locked doors, people shouldn't talk about it.
Well, yeah, basically.
Homosexuals should be ostracised.
That's right. Our kids are growing up now, and, personally, I don't want my kid to grow up hearing the word homosexuality. That'll be a perfect life for him. So when he's growing up, there's no one gay out there, you know. It's terrible, that would.
So you reckon that by not talking about it, by repressing it, by removing any reference to it in newspapers, television, never mind a vote in the Houses of Parliament, it'll just go away?
That's right. Well...
Okie dokie. Thanks for that, Julian. Who have we got on this line here? Hello? Okay, we'll go to Alan next. Alan's on this line. Morning, Alan.
Hello, hiya. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
I just want to talk about the age of consent, first of all. I'm a gay man, and I've been to nightclubs and stuff, and I've seen 16 or 17-year-olds there, and I feel that I don't think they should... be able to be there, but I just think that they aren't ready. You know, you can tell when someone is ready to come out or not, or to go to these places.
What do you mean by ready?
Well, I mean, I think 21, and in my mind I had all these sort of dirty nightclubs or black rooms, you know, all these people going to touch me and stuff, and I'm sorry, but it's just not like that at all. And people have this impression of gay people, and I think that gay people are their own worst enemies in the fact that you only hear the negative side of what, you know, what gay people do. And people just pick on that, they don't look at anything.
But then you see, if you started publicising the positive side, whatever that may be, then you get people like our previous caller accusing you of conducting a recruitment campaign.
No, absolutely not, because I
No, no, but you see that I'm not saying that you do, I'm saying that that is the accusation that would be levelled if you started saying that you raise a lot of money for charity or whatever.
No, I agree with that entirely. I mean, whenever I hear some... I mean, I was at a party on Monday and I heard there was one gay bloke and a straight bloke and... apparently the straight bloke had been saying, like, making jabs at this, at my friend, and they had this conversation about it, and I said, look, you know, you have no right to push you being gay down this person's throat, and therefore you don't really have any right to judge anybody else, which is how I look at it, and I don't thrust or don't make people like me or speak to me because I'm gay, and I don't make it an issue. If I'm introduced to somebody, then, you know, I am Alan, I'm not anybody else.
Alan the gay person.
Yeah, and I can see people's opinions when they're saying things like, well, they're dirty and stuff like that, because that's how we are, that's how people think of us.
Why do they think of you like that?
I just think because it was all underground, etc., you know, in the 40s and 50s, and it's so popular now. You had, I think, one caller saying that, one, that there weren't enough people, you know, that there weren't enough gay people to find partners. Well, I'm sorry, there are. I don't have a partner, and but that's because I don't want one, and I personally don't believe that I could live with another man. I don't want to, and I don't think that men and men relationships work, but having said that, I'm not into casual sex at all. I you know, perhaps it's just because I haven't met the right partner, but I don't want people to believe that it's all, you know...
It's all sex?
It's all sex. So it's not at all. There's lots.
Are you celibate at the moment, then?
Well, yeah, I mean... By choice, not because, you know...
No, I understand that.
Yeah,
but just,
I am,
you are
yeah.
celibate at the moment.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, Alan, can you just hold on there? Because we've got to take the news, and then we'll get back to you after that. 754-123 in Wolverhampton, 236-235 in Shrewsbury. It's the Midnight Line on Beacon and WABC, discussing the vote that's likely to take place in the Houses of Parliament on whether or not the age of homosexual consent should be lowered from 21 to 16. We'll be back after this. Beacon
Radio. The 1 o'clock news, this is Philip Cottrell. Two British drug smugglers are due home this morning, freed from jail and deported from Thailand. Karen Smith and Patricia Carhill are flying to Heathrow. They were granted a royal pardon after John Major's intervention. Birmingham police want to question them about the West Midlands gang behind their smuggling operation. Patricia's grand Kitty says someone must have paid for their air tickets and fake documents.
She had a passport which was forged, somebody forged a father's signature on it. I mean, it was a whole forgery, our passport was. Some evil men out there still, you know. I want justice, and I want answers. And my father wants answers.
A 39-year-old man will appear in court this morning, charged with murdering one of five gay men killed in London. Unemployed Colin Ireland, of no fixed address, is accused of killing care worker Andrew Collier. Collier was the fourth of five murder victims linked by the police, who say inquiries are continuing into the other deaths. Dozens of people caught working illegally on a fruit farm in Kent are expected to be deported today. In all, 81 people were rounded up in a joint operation between police and immigration officers at the farm near Ashford. The Home Office has described the raid as the biggest of its kind. The detainees are mainly from Eastern Europe, with three from South America. MPs vote on the social chapter opt-out from the Maastricht Treaty today, and rebel Conservatives could severely embarrass the government. The Prime Minister has already made personal appeals to the Eurosceptics, asking them not to side with Labour and the Liberal Democrats, but a hard core of backbench Tories still seem determined to vote against the government. One of the leading rebels, Bill Cash, says there's no possibility of the government falling because of any rebellion today.
If there were a confidence motion, I would certainly vote for the government. The Labour and Liberal Democrats are utterly devoted to the idea of a federal Europe and all that goes with it. And I would immediately vote with the government on a confidence motion.
Independent Radio News.
The latest satellite picture is produced by John Warner from orbital station Meteosat 4. The most accurate forecast.
Rain spreading into the area from the southwest by dawn. The low 10 Celsius, 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Later today, rain at first turning to drizzle by midday. It's going to become rather warm and close by the afternoon. Maximum temperature 20 Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit. The outlook Friday in the weekend, rather cool and showery. Temperature now 10 Celsius, 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Midnight Line on Beacon and WABC, talking about whether or not the age of gay consent should be lowered or not. We were speaking to Alan before we went to the news, and he's back again. Morning again, Alan.
Hiya, alright.
Yeah, now you were saying that you were celibate,
mm-hmm.
for of your own choice.
Yeah.
For whatever reasons, uh-huh. Not because you're ugly.
No.
No, I want to make that absolutely. Right, yeah. Before the libel slander writ come flying through the post.
Right.
When you listen to... I mean, you said you understood why people say, oh, it's dirty, oh, it's filthy, oh, it should be banned. Doesn't it make you angry?
No, it doesn't, because I mean, perhaps I'm not an odd one out or anything like that, but I look at it as, like, it's what I do, and I don't judge people anyway, but I just think it's because I'm that way doesn't mean that people have to accept me because I do that. I mean, I talk to my gay friends and they can't quite understand what it is I'm trying to say, but I am who I am. I'm not anybody else, and I don't want anyone else to be anything else for me, if that makes sense to you.
Yeah, fair enough. You don't judge people, you don't want people to judge you.
Mm-hmm.
And if they do, who cares?
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't come on tonight to think, oh yeah, I've got to stick up for gay people, because I'm not, you know. But people, I mean, I cannot believe how many gay people there are. And it's increasing as well, it really is. I mean, I go to a club in Wolverhampton, and it's just so many people there. And I think a lot of people at 16 would think, oh my God, I'm the only one, this is the only one happening to me. I did it, I think everyone does it. And I don't think at 16 you are mentally able to cope with all the stresses that go with it.
Are heterosexuals?
No, I don't think so, no. You know, I wasn't... Well, I knew that I was gay, but I mean, you know, I didn't accept it until I was 21 and, you know, practically dragged out by my friends. But I think at 16 you're more vulnerable and you could be taken... I mean, there are people that would take advantage of a 16-year-old. And there are. The same. I mean, they are straight people that would... Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. I think within any population there are all sorts of different types and different attitudes, aren't there?
Mm-hmm. So I think that 16, although you're not going to stop people going to gay clubs or being gay at 16, because if they are, they know about it anyway. But I think that it should be sort of like, I think 18 is probably quite a sensible age. But there again, that's not, you know, I still think you have problems at 18.
And you experienced these problems?
Yeah. I mean,
what was the worst bit?
Was going to the first... I mean, first of all, for telling my friends who knew I was, and like the whole summer tried to get me to tell them that I was, and I just didn't. And I knew that they were. In fact, yeah, only one of them was at that point. And then when I went to the first gay club, I was like terrified, thinking, oh my God, this is going to happen to me, and this is going to happen to me, because of all the bad publicity that I'd got. But... when I got there, I was thinking, what's your problem, you know? I mean, I've never been approached or ever been, you know, what's the word I'm looking for? I've never been approached.
Never been pressured?
Yeah, or pressured, yeah. I mean, I just go out, I have a few drinks with my friends and I have a good time. I mean, I take my married women friends with me, and, like, women adore gay clubs because there's no pressure for them there. I think we're moving off issue here, but...
No, it doesn't matter.
The gay scene is a lot more friendly, and I went to Nottingham recently, and I went to a straight pub and a club, and I felt threatened, not because anyone knew what I was, but I just, there wasn't the same atmosphere there, I didn't enjoy it, and not because I was looking for anyone to pick up with, because I wasn't, you know, I was out with my girlfriend and having a drink. It's totally different. I think people who say it should be banned, etc., you know, why, what's their problem, and...
See, I was, a friend of mine is gay,
mm-hmm.
and he took me to a gay club one night.
Yeah.
Because I said I'd never been to one, and I just wanted to go and see what one was like.
Yeah.
And I was quite ashamed of myself, because all my petty prejudices came rushing out. I was so defensive, it was unbelievable.
Why?
I don't know.
Naturally defensive because you're
just
in that situation.
Yeah, I just got dead defensive. But what was really funny was that nobody took offence at me being defensive and talking like that and things.
I mean,
and clinging on to any woman I could find. Yeah, hey, look at me, I'm a hetero.
Yeah, yeah.
And they just took the mickey. I tell you, one of the funniest things that's ever happened to me is I went to the bar because it was my round. I've been putting it off for ages. And I went to the bar and I said, 4 pints of lager, please. And the guy went, right, what sort would you like? I said, any. So he went off and he came back with these lagers. And he said, I said, how much is that? He said, well, that'll be £4.86 or whatever it was. Mm-hmm. I gave him a note, right? So he went away and he came back with my change and he said, thank you very much. And I put my hand out to receive my change. As he put my change down, what he did was stroked the inside of my...
That broke my palm.
I tell you, man, I let... Have you ever seen those cartoons with Bugs Bunny in them?
Yeah.
Where he leaps, suddenly leaps about 30 foot in the air. But he was taking the mickey.
Yeah, because they know they can sense that. I mean, this was the argument. You know, I told you about I went to the party on Monday. That's what I said. Look, you know, you felt threatened because it was a room full of, like, mostly gay people, and you felt that... Not, and he turned out that not consciously, but subconsciously, he was making these comments that my friend had picked up on. I didn't pick on them. I think, you do. You get sort of, and quite reasonably so, you know, you get defensive because you...
Because it's different. I think that's different. What it was.
And that thing about them taking the mick out of you, yeah, they do, but they don't mean it.
I didn't mind that. I thought when I was away from the situation and I looked back at it, I thought it was very funny.
I mean, I've had that happen to me when... I've gone to bar and someone's done that to me, and you know, I just like, ugh, I'm sorry, I don't want to know, you know, up it.
I was up through the air, hadn't I? Absolutely. Go on, we're going.
But I really do think that people have the right to have these sort of assumptions of what gay people are like. But speaking of someone who's not, I mean, I am completely gay, but I do have like not hang-ups in terms of what I am or what goes on. But people I've met have just been so friendly, and I've never ever had any bad experiences.
Okie dokie, listen, we're going to have to move on though.
Right.
Thanks for talking
to
us.
Bye-bye.
Ta-ra. Next on the lines, we've got Brian. Brian's on this line, then we've got Diane. Brian.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'm your most articulate caller from the discussion about religion the other week.
Oh, right, okay. Brian.
But I don't feel very erudite this evening because I'm a bit annoyed with your callers.
What are you annoyed about?
Well, the attitude, basically. I mean, to start, I mean, about 10% of the population that they reckon is gay, I think it's higher than that. And I think if all gay people or all people with gay tendencies or feelings suddenly turn green overnight, every single one of your listeners would know someone personally, that a member of their family who is gay, and they'd have friends who are gay. The reason people don't admit to it is because of the prejudice that they've expressed. I mean, can you imagine what it's like to have to live your life denying a basic facet of your personality, which is sexuality, which I did till I was 30 years old, because of the hostility on it would have got. And as far as sort of persuading other people goes, that's impossible. I mean, all people are brought up with negative images about gay people. All the adverts, all the advertising images in the media, it's all basically straight.
Yeah, I was. I mean, one of the nastiest jibes you could hand out when I was at school was, I mean, one guy, because he was slightly effeminate, was the class Puff.
Yeah.
We called him Puff.
Yeah.
Why? Because he was quite a gentle bloke, that was it. He wasn't like the rest of us ruffians.
Yeah.
And so we called him a Puff.
Yeah, that's right.
And that sounds sort of reasonably trivial until you realise that you've got to look underneath that thought process, and there's a lot, as you say, a lot of hostility there. Why does that hostility exist?
Well, I think from people who are sort of really vitriolic about it, in many cases, I think it's because they've subconsciously or unconsciously rather have desires themselves, and they project it out onto people who are openly gay because they can't handle the gay feelings within themselves. I think that happens quite a lot. I think that when they say that, you know, people will be converted and stuff, you can't be, I mean, they must really find an attractive proposition, something so tempting it's got to be legislated against. You know, because if you're not interested, then there's no way that you will be persuaded to do it. I mean, gay people wouldn't exist if you could be persuaded otherwise, because there is no positive images at all going around, but you still follow your nature in the end.
Are our more vitriolic callers, are they getting a little upset because if you lowered the age of gay consent, it's another one of their defences crumbling?
Yes, exactly. I mean, if you analyse their arguments, they don't have any. I mean, mostly it's just bigotry and prejudice. Then there are three of the things which they cite. The first one is AIDS, which we know that it is a heterosexual problem worldwide, more than a homosexual problem.
There's more than that. I actually think it's very dangerous to refer to it as a gay disease.
Oh, it is. I mean, The Sun used to do that. They used to say, well, some papers still do that now, don't they?
Well, the reason it's so dangerous is because then heterosexuals conduct themselves like it's never going
to
affect them.
Yeah, exactly. It leads people to believe that it's not their problem, so they can go and have unsaid sex. And, of course, it's such a time bomb thing. It takes about 15 years to develop.
Because when it first came out, sort of mid-80s, and they were calling it a gay disease, I was thinking, well, I'm all right. they're not going to affect me. But of course, you know, 10 years later, or wherever we are now, 9 years later, 7 years later, maths was never my strong point. It's a it's just as dangerous for heterosexuals as it is for homosexuals.
Of course, the disease doesn't discriminate in the bloodstream. It couldn't care less once it gets into the body fluids.
Well, 7 years ago, I was hiding behind this, I'm all right, I'm heterosexual.
I think many people still do today, and they're encouraged to do so by many newspapers. There was one of the editors on the Sunday papers interviewed on the television this week. I can't remember who it is now. Might have been not Murdoch. Neil. What's his name?
Donald.
No.
Andrew Neil.
Andrew Neil, that's right. Sunday expresses it.
Times. Just being told in my ear.
Right, well, he was saying that. He still says that now. But there shouldn't be any government funding because it's basically a gay problem, which is a minority of the population. It doesn't affect most healthy heterosexuals, which is absolutely untrue. It is worldwide, there are more heterosexual cases. So, I mean, that isn't a valid objection to being homosexual. In any case, two homosexuals together who are not infected are not going to spread it to anybody else in any case, so it's an invalid argument.
Now, you were 30.
Yeah.
Before you admitted to others and to yourself, was it?
To myself, yeah.
That you were homosexual.
Yeah, I used to go out to the straight pubs and the straight nightclubs on a Saturday night with my straight friends and live a lie. I mean, I knew, but I denied it, and I used to...
When did you know?
I've known all my life, really. But I wouldn't admit it to myself, and I wouldn't behave. See, the only sort of images I'd got were the stereotypes, the John Inman type. I thought, well, that's not me, that can't be me, so I wouldn't go along with it. And I'd pretend week in and day out, and laugh to the gay jokes, and pretend to chat the girls up and go home by myself and be unhappy.
I must admit, I had exactly the same John Inman stereotype.
Mm.
And until me and my mates went to Amsterdam for a weekend, and we went into this bar. And I was sat there looking at these, I was thinking, it's a funny bar, this, they're all blokes, and they're all wearing leather hats.
Yeah.
And they're all about 15 stone, and, they're all gay, boys, out.
Exactly, I know truck drivers and factory workers, I mean, there is nobody's exempt from it. Obviously, it's 10% randomly throughout society, and I think it's more than that, really.
Could you have dealt with it before you were 30?
Personally, I didn't, so probably the answer is no, but the reason I couldn't and the reason I didn't was because of the sort of attitudes that have been expressed this evening and are expressed all the time and reinforced all the time. We're constantly told it's immoral, we're dirty. The woman earlier on said she'd give the wages for the killer to pay the killer. This is the sort of attitude that you have to live with, and you have to be very brave to sort of shrug all that off and openly come out and live a lifestyle, which is why the vast majority of people don't.
On that basis, then, would you say that the higher the age of consent, the more it protects?
No, I wouldn't. I don't think that the age of consent is the issue. I think the age of consent should be the same, no matter what your sexual orientation. And I think other laws should equally apply. I think we should have rights that other people enjoy and not be discriminated against under the law, which we are. We can't get married. I mean, if they prefer us to have stable relationships rather than be promiscuous, why aren't we allowed to get married and cement those relationships in a legal framework, get the relatives along so that it's all official and you get support. If the relationship hits a rocky patch, you get the families coming and helping out. You don't get any of that in a gay relationship. So no wonder they're more transient, given you don't get society's approval to begin with. I think society needs to be educated, just like it was over women's issues. I mean, women were denied the vote, as we all know, and against sort of non.
Still are in parts of Yorkshire.
Well, sure they are, yeah. and also the same thing applied used to apply before the Race Relations Act was passed to people who are non-British on ethnic origin. You know, you need education. All ignorance basically is, all sort of prejudice basically is based on ignorance, in my experience. And you need...
And fear,
yeah. But that comes through ignorance as well, because I think unless you've actually gone out and experienced gay lifestyles and met lots of gay people and educated yourself, then you're totally ignorant. I mean, people always talk in terms of sex. They always say, well, as long as they do what they want to do behind closed doors, it doesn't bother me. That's seeing simply as a physical issue, and it isn't. It's an emotional issue. You don't just want to go and have sex. You want to have a relationship as a human being with another human being. It's not a question of just going behind closed doors and having sex, is it?
But that's how I would agree with you. Most heterosexual people view homosexuality as purely a sex thing.
Yes, and I'm saying that it definitely is not that. We all have emotional needs that need to be met in fulfillment with another human being, and if you're gay, it has to be with a person of the same sex. And it isn't just a case of, you know, what we do behind closed doors. That's reducing it to the most basic functional level, and there is far more to it than that. It's the sort of soulmate search that every human being indulges in. You know, so they talk about AIDS, they talk about religion. That's another favourite topic. It says in the Bible. But how many of those people follow the Bible to the book? You know, and religion surely is about compassion and tolerance.
Well, the Cardinal Hume, my research department, are telling me that Cardinal Hume, the Roman Catholic Archbishop of Westminster, told homosexuals that while homosexual acts are objectively wrong, they should not feel guilty about their sexual orientation.
Yes, I know, I read that.
People who know themselves to be homosexual must not develop a sense of guilt or think of themselves as unpleasing to God. On the contrary, they are precious in the eyes of God. Is that a move in the right direction?
It's a move in the right direction, yes it is. And I think
I've always thought half the clergy were closet gays anyway.
Well, they are. They absolutely are. I mean, I know quite a few myself. There's no doubt about it. And if you're going to walk around in a frock all day, what do you expect, you know?
I've never understood why the Roman Catholic Church going to ordain women priests. They're like the male ones. The male ones walk around in frocks. Oh, if only you knew.
I mean, the other argument that you always get coming across is the children thing, you know, like they'll pick on the children. I mean, again, this is a total fabrication. 98% of sex offenders against children are heterosexual. That is a fact. Being a paedophile, being homosexual, and being heterosexual are three distinct things. You know, there is no prevalence amongst gay men to go after children. They are not interested in children. They're after people of the same sex who are mature. That's another myth that needs to be exploded, really. It's just basically not true.
Where do these myths come from?
I think they all come out, well, basically, again, it's ignorance. People just aren't aware and don't want to inform themselves. They are afraid.
Of what they might find?
I think of what they may find. I think possibly there's a much deeper thing that they may be tempted themselves, or a member of the family might be corrupted into it, which I've said isn't the case. It just can't happen. If you could be taught your sexuality, there wouldn't be any gay people anyway. And
I'd agree with that because of the amount of anti-gay propaganda that sort of smashes around society. If it was purely an educational thing, you would learn to avoid the stress.
Yeah, and it says a lot for the human spirit, and despite all that negative image and the fact that it used to be illegal, it still went on because some people are, and that's the end of the matter. They just are. But why should they have to tolerate all that prejudice? Why should that be allowed to go on? Why should people be made to feel so miserable because of the fact that they are sexually attracted to the same gender? They don't harm anybody else. It's consenting adults. Nobody's going to be corrupted. They're not offending anybody, or they shouldn't be offending anybody else. I mean, the law is ridiculous. I mean, if you're in the street and you hold hands with another man, and a member of the public takes offence and comes over and hits you, the person who hit you is going to be prosecuted. Sorry, the person who was hit is going to be prosecuted under public order offence.
What, for holding hands?
Yeah. You know, I mean, showing affection to somebody else in public gives someone else the right to hit you.
Can it just cannot be right. Listen, Brian, very articulate again. I've got to move on, but you reckon that at least if you drop the age of consent, it would be a move towards putting homosexuals on a par with heterosexuals, not just on the sex thing?
I think lots of changes could and should be made to give parity in many areas, such as marriage, employment laws. It is legal to fire someone because you happen to find out that they're gay and they can't get any redress under the law, they can't get any compensation, even if it doesn't interfere with their work. There have been lots of cases of that. People have been fired to 25 to 30 years and they can't get their job back or any compensation just because they found out that privately they're gay. So employment laws should be changed. People should be allowed to get married just the same, and the laws of consent should apply equally. There shouldn't be any legalised discrimination.
And a move towards total parity?
Of course. I mean, why not? What is the threat?
Okie dokie, thanks for that.
Okay.
Speak to you again.
All right, then.
Ta-ra.
Bye.
There we go, very articulate chat. Brian on the Midnight Line at Beacon and WABC. We got Diana next. Good morning.
Good morning.
Same name as my own mother.
Oh,
Well, it's a brilliant name, you see.
It is a totally cracking name, Diana. You're absolutely right.
Did yes,
you?
I'm
did...
afraid I'm another one of Johnny Morris's 8%. You seem to be getting a few of us on at the moment.
Oh, you are you?
Yeah.
Just for anybody who hasn't quite followed the logic behind that, what you're saying is that you're gay?
Yes, that's right.
Right, okay, fair enough. Can I watch?
Well, after your last caller being so eloquent, there's not a lot for me left to say, actually.
Well, I suppose you look at it from a different... You've got to look at it from a different angle as a woman, haven't you? Because, you see, secretly, heterosexual blokes actually think, I would say a vast majority of them, think that two women together is quite a turn-on.
Well, they probably think that all we need is a good bonking, if you excuse the expression, to put us right.
It's an adult show, Diana.
Well, I could think of a better word, but I wouldn't say it on the air. There's just one caller that's disturbed me slightly. It's Julian, who was on about somebody approaching his son in 10 years' time. Well, the thing that worries me is, suppose his son is gay. Now, how on earth is he going to cope with that?
Yes. never darken this.
Attitude,
never
you know.
Darken this doorway again would tend to spring to mind, wouldn't it?
Son isn't gay. I mean, it's not something that you choose, as we've established.
No, I mean, I came home the other week only to find that my nephew's announced that he's a Manchester United supporter.
Well, there's no accounting for taste at all, is there?
Pardon?
There's no accounting for taste.
Absolutely not. I mean, as a Liverpool supporter myself, I was totally distraught.
Well, when you support Blackpool, you've got to allow for everything.
Oh, you're from there, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, just up the coast from my old mother's.
That's right.
As a female,
yes.
are your experiences different from your male counterparts? Or do you suffer the same thing? Do people accept lesbians? I mean, do you mind being called a lesbian? I don't know what's politically correct to call people.
Yeah, I know some gay friends of mine do object to being called lesbians. I think it's an awful word, but I am what I am. Whatever you want to call me, it doesn't change what I am.
And when did you first realise?
Well, I think I've known since I was old enough to know about sexuality. I think I've known. But the same as one or two of your other callers, I wouldn't accept it. You know, I tried to be straight. I tried going to the normal nightclubs and trying to be normal. And I've had boyfriends and all the rest.
But it just didn't work for you?
It didn't work for me, no. When I was about 21, I came out, if you like, had an opportunity. And to me, it was like a light being turned on. You know, it was just everything that I'd always wanted, but I hadn't admitted to myself or anybody else.
Why do you believe that was? Were you playing a role?
Yeah, I think it's the same as you said. All the conditioning you get from youth, all the advertising, everything else. It's all trying to direct you to be normal, to be straight, to be everything that the role tells you to be, and when all the time inside you know it's not right for you, but you don't even admit it to yourself at the time.
Brian said he was 30 when he admitted it to himself. You said you were 21.
Yeah.
Is it possible that you didn't admit it to yourself until you were 21 because you weren't able to?
Quite possibly, yeah.
So then, should
I think the consent age should be the same, because whatever you make the age, people are going to break it anyway. If you make it 18, there's still going to be 16-year-olds and 14-year-olds walking around doing it.
Yeah, I accept that, but it's as I said before. I don't believe
well,
that any
stand. Yeah, no.
Any no law on sexuality is practical to enforce, really. I mean, you're going to get the odd one here and there. And I suppose it's quite useful when sort of blokes have sex with underage girls and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But I think it's largely a moral stance.
Yeah. I think it should be 18 anyway, but, I mean, you'd have to change an awful lot of things. I mean, you couldn't have people getting married at 16 and not being allowed to have sex till they're 18, could you?
No,
just the age of consent is the same question, you know.
Yes, that's fair. That's a fair point.
In an ideal world, I would say at least 18, but to be practical, you can't do that.
Have you, when you go about your life,
mm-hmm.
are you reasonably open about your sexuality? Or is it never really an issue?
To an extent, I'm open about it. I don't care who knows about me. If they ask me, I would tell them. But on the other hand, it's not something you go around waving a flag about, because, you know, some quarters would frown upon it. Also, you might meet somebody that is discreet, and they don't want you walking around, you know, advertising it.
On their behalf?
On their behalf, or on your own behalf, if you're out with them, sort of thing.
Yes, hey, guess what, she's a lesbian, yeah.
That's
understand that, especially if they're from a church-going family or something.
Mm.
Have you ever actively encountered discrimination?
Oh, yes. When I was 16, I split friends with somebody. Well, we'd been to school together for 5 years. She moved to Scotland, and we'd been writing together to each other for 5 years after that, till I was 21. Then I wrote to her and told her that I was gay. And we exchanged furious letters for about a fortnight. I don't know whether she was trying to insinuate that I was saying that she was as well, but and I've never heard from her since. And yet we've been friends all that time, 10 years.
And that was it?
And that was it, yeah.
End of story.
Yeah.
Sad, isn't it?
It is. Okay. I often wonder, you know, what she's doing now. You know, she's at university in Glasgow.
Oh, she's in Scotland?
As far as I know, yeah.
Still, she could be in the area.
Might be.
You'd be amazed where this show gets.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, listen, I've got to move on.
Yeah.
But thanks for that. You reckon 18?
Well, I reckon that nobody really knows. But on the other hand, as long as it's not doing anybody any damage, you know, as long as, you know, there's not a lot of people walking around getting pregnant and one thing or another, I don't see really the harm in experimenting, because until you experiment, you don't know what you are.
I don't know about that. I mean, I would agree that it is probably useful at some stage in your career to examine your sexuality. I get the feeling that homophobia comes from people who haven't actually examined their own sexuality.
Possibly.
I mean, I did actually ask myself the question was, am I gay? And I came to the conclusion that I couldn't possibly be because I didn't fancy blokes.
Yeah. I think everybody is basically bisexual. But then it comes down to preference. Because everybody has a certain feeling for the human man, whether it's man or woman. And you can feel a certain empathy to another human being, whatever sex you are, whatever sex they are. So I think everything is basically, you know, drawn to human beings. And then it comes down to a matter of, for your sexual needs, which do you prefer?
Well, I'm with you on that one. I prefer women.
Well, perhaps you've got good taste, I don't know.
Listen, thanks for talking to us.
It's been a pleasure.
Okie dokie.
Bye-bye now.
Ta-ra. We've got Trevor on the lines, we've got Nap, we've got Pearl, we've got Anna, and we've got Merion. And we'll speak to those after we take the track from our featured CD at Beacon and WABC Towers this morning. It is the Police.
Thank you. they try and try. Strong words in the staff room, the accusations fly. It's no use, he sees her, he starts to shake, he starts.